Bruce, you said you're going to focus on PK after the main skate today, using Hughes on the first pair. You plan to get him some more minutes that way?
Yeah. Well, I mean, I don't think it was a basis. We had four sets of defense when he went out first. So, I mean, I wouldn't say he was the first pair. I mean, look, there's a lot of times where he's going to be on the ice for a minute and then you get a penalty. So, but, I mean, he's going to be one of the penalty killers, and I plan on using him again. I mean, there's not too many better people in the league of if the puck's on the stick that he's going to be able to get it out, and the quickness of getting in on corners and retrieving pucks, you know. So, I mean, those guys are really good for the penalty kill.
Bo wasn't part of the group today. He's such a face-off ace, but is that something you're going to take off his plate?
No, he's not playing tomorrow. So, I mean, a lot of the guys who are playing tomorrow were practicing the penalty killing, and a lot of guys that weren't. You know, so
what they mentioned, Ken Lazar, range of the PK.
Well, you just look like, I mean, he's not a kid. He's experienced at doing it. Teams he's been on, whether it be Calgary or Boston, both have always had good penalty kills. He's been part of it, and I just thought he looked like a real professional out there today. I thought he was one of the few guys that I could sit there and go, man, he's going to be good in that spot.
You didn't, I mean, it was so new after practice yesterday with Dermott. Is there an update?
No, he's just not feeling good. So, you know, I mean, and that sometimes that happens. So he's not feeling good. We're not going to, at this stage, I mean, let him practice. If this is, if it lingers on, we'll see how it goes after that. But right now, it's just, he wasn't feeling better, and Tyler Myers was feeling fine, so I mean, just did the switch.
Dermott, was it the contact, Bruce, or?
Hey, you know what, I was right there, and it didn't look like much. So I mean, I don't know, maybe twisted something the wrong way, and you know, like sometimes that happens. So,
Bruce, what do you see in Phil DiGiuseppe? He had a terrific camp here last year. I think a lot of us thought he was going to make the team. It didn't happen for him, but to the eye, he kind of looks the part of an NHL guy.
Well, I mean, I thought he was good in Carolina and in New York when I'd watch him from afar. And he can skate, and he's big, and he doesn't mind playing physical. I think last year he didn't make it out of camp, then he broke his leg and he got injured, and I wanted to call him up, but he broke his, did something else to himself, and so it was just a wasted year. You know, especially with a couple guys hurt, he's going to get, you know, every chance to show how good he can be, and hopefully he's pushing other people for jobs.
You gave Carlson a look today with Petey and Kuzmenko. What did you see there?
Well, I mean, I he's a goal scorer, and from rookie camp to now, he's gotten better. He's adjusting more to the speed. So I thought he'd be playing with Petey tomorrow. So, I mean, let's see him today. And I went out and talked to him. I said, you know, you're doing fine, but, I mean, now's the time. You know, you've got to open everybody's eyes. You've got to open everybody's eyes by doing what you do. So hopefully we'll see that tomorrow.
It's a methodical climb back for a guy like Tucker Poolman, who's had the migraine issues. He said, you know, let's get him in there. Let's throw him in there. Let's get him into some preseason games. What have you seen so far? Does he look tentative?
No, he doesn't look tentative. He looks fine. The timing is going to be off in the game. So, I mean, that's why he's playing tomorrow, when we get the timing back for him. But, I mean, if he can, when he got hurt when he was in Winnipeg, he was playing extremely well. And if he can play, get to that level again, then, you know, all of a sudden we were thinking all summer we might not have something, and now we've got a guy that we know can play real well.
Most teams like to carry AD, and Burrows actually made the opening night roster last year because he's this feisty guy who's pretty good in his own zone, and before the rib injury he was playing pretty well too. I know it's early, but what do you see in him?
Well, I see exactly what you said. Like, I mean, he brings a physicality for a small guy. He's well liked in the room. He comes out here and works every day. I mean, and he's you know, when you've got that taste of the NHL, you're going to make it difficult for you to do something with him. And, you know, that's what we're hoping he does with us.
Are you intending to get another look at Danny DeCastro?
Yes.
And what have you seen from him since?
You know what I mean? He's a pro player. You can tell the way he carries himself. We just want to see if there's a good fit with, you know, our defenseman and how that works out. But he's right in the mix. Like, I mean, the one thing we were talking about today is is even though we've got eight and say Dermott would be a ninth, there's six. Abbotsford's going to have a real good defense, and we could bring any one of those guys up, and we'll bring a couple more guys up from them to play in the Seattle game. But we like the depth of our defense, that guys that can play and have played games in the NHL, and that's not even including Rathbone, you know, who's going to get a chance in four or five of the games, and if he keeps, you know, improving, good things can happen for him.
You had three goalies out?
Yeah. Well, we had Seeloff's out yesterday, and that was to reward him for... He's been so good. But, I mean, we don't want to all of a sudden sit there and say, you know, Demko's number one. But we brought, you know, the other two guys to fight for the job. We're not giving Martin the job. He's got to earn it. So, you know.
Sorry.
Go ahead.
Talk a little about Rathbone's progress and where he's at.
You know, from the first moment he stepped on the ice to me to now, he's really come along. He takes direction well. I mean, he wants to play. So, I mean, let's, I think he could, you know, I think he's an up-and-comer. Hopefully there's, we'll see if there's room at the start and go from there.
You also, Hoglander was an extra on a different line today.
Well, you know what, they're not necessarily extras. I put four, we've got 14 forwards, so I got to write three down and then somebody else. And he wasn't, yesterday he was with Petey. Today, he, you know, I put him with Almond. I wanted to keep him with the Swedish guys. But, I mean, it's just I told them right at the beginning, it's so you guys are all rotating. So, I mean, that's not, I don't think it's the right way to say an extra. Sorry. You know.